Hey guys, so Dirt 5 came out this week, and I've been on a little racing game kick as of late, so I thought I'd pick it up on release day to see how it is. The Rally Racing series by Codemasters has taken more of an arcadey approach in the past few iterations, and the latest installment in the franchise doesn't veer far away from this, being as bombastic as ever. It makes sense since the introduction of the more sim-focused Dirt Rally series and lets the series take on some more outlandish risks, for better or worse. If you have Dirt 5, let me know how you like it so far in the comments, and don't forget to like this video and subscribe so you don't miss out on more content. I always like a good analogy, and if last week's Art of Rally is bold and refined like a good scotch, Dirt 5 is the frat party jungle juice. Still good, and it'll get the job done, but you might want to take some penicillin after. Just saying. Like most racing games, the bulk of the content is found within the game's career mode. While there's not much of a story to tell besides being an up-and-coming driver in the dirt scene, it is narrated by Donut Media's James Pumphrey and Nolan Sykes. In addition to the Donut Media crew, Troy Baker and Nolan North voiced the two main characters your player interacts with throughout the game. The verdict's out on whether or not it's a worthwhile addition, as I haven't finished the campaign, but interesting nonetheless to see such high-profile voice actors providing their talents to a racing game of all things. Progression is made in individual events by earning stamps. Doing better in each race can earn you up to 3. After the first few events, the game opens up a little bit, and you get to start choosing which events you want to complete. Progressing and earning enough stamps allows you into the main event of each chapter, which is more difficult than the others, requiring you to place 3rd or higher to move on. In terms of the actual gameplay, it's more of the same arcade racing action that has made the series successful for better or worse. This is definitely an arcade game. If you want more of a sim racing experience, you'll want to look towards the Dirt Rally series or elsewhere for your fix. It is nice, though, having the options to change driver assists on the fly, and can easily level out the learning curve for a more inexperienced driver. The variety of event types in Dirt 5 are plentiful, but I always had the most fun with the classic circuit and point-to-point races using, you know, your standard variety of rally cars. The rally raid trucks and super lights tended to be my least favorite type of car, outside of the dreaded sprint car. I wanted to avoid these races at all cost. In addition to the career mode, there is an online mode on PC, allowing you to start a lobby with friends or choose between a race type or a party mode type. Once you're in the playlist, though, you're randomly added to a lobby. There's no real selection in what type of event you can play. You're just kind of thrown in. I really didn't spend much time here. The place I did spend some time in was the Playgrounds mode. For the first time, you can actually build and share your own type of dirt event and share it with the community. It's reminiscent of the Tony Hawk series and the Create a Park feature that were in those games. And there seems to be a ton of potential if the people become interested. I played a handful of different community tracks, and some of them rivaled the tracks in the main game when it came to the fun factor. Stepping into its first next-gen iteration, Dirt 5 is actually a mixed bag visually, in my opinion. While cars look great and smash up even better, many of the environments are somewhat fuzzy in comparison. They don't really do anything to stand out. The real standout here are the weather effects, though. Rain, snow, and mud are all detailed in one of the most impressive implementations I've ever seen in a game. Track deformation throughout a race seems to actually change the characteristics of the car's handling as well. Outside of the game's voice acting, the audio has some highs and lows. Cars sound great, but the game's soundtrack is forgettable. It's a basic blend of electronic music and pop rock that could fit right into Target's next ad campaign. This is not near the level of a classic soundtrack like Burnout 3 Takedown or Need for Speed Underground 2. If you're looking for something to show off your new Xbox Series X or PlayStation 5, Dirt 5 might be a good choice if you're a racing fan. If you're looking for a more complete package, I'd say Forza Horizon 4 is still your best bet on Microsoft consoles. And it's even getting a day one upgrade for the Series X specifically. So that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching this video. Are you planning on getting Dirt 5? Do you already have it? Let me know what you think about it in the comments. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe for more gaming content.